Good evening, friends. My name is Vineet, and today I'm here to discuss the importance of GA in GATE, PSU, and government jobs. Before taking through you the importance of GA, I want to share some basic information about GATE. I'm sure you must be knowing these information. I just want to reiterate these informations. As you know, the total number of questions in GATE is 65 and the total marks is 100, in which there are 30 one-mark questions and 35 two-mark questions. And also, the types of questions are two, MCQs and numerical-based answers. In MCQ, you have 33% negative marking, so be careful in answering MCQs. Now, I want to take you through various subjects and their weightages. I have taken this data from last 5 years. If you'll see any stream, you'll see there are 8 to 10 core subjects and mathematics and GA is there. If you want to see the weightages, you have the weightages of the core subjects will be around 70 to 72 marks, mathematics will be around 13 to 15 marks, and GA is of 15 marks. So if you look at this, do you think this 28 to 30 mark is important? I'll show you one slide. Now, look at this. These are the cutoffs. If you look at the journal category, the cutoffs are ranging from 25 to 29. That means you can qualify a GATE only by focusing on these two subjects, mathematics and GA. But I'm sure you're not here to only qualify the GATE. You want to score good marks so that you can get good college. Now, you must be wondering, what is good marks? So, I want to show you. Check this. If you look at this information, you'll come to know that if you score 50 plus, then definitely you can get a good college. These data are taken on an average basis. In some year, when the paper is tough, these numbers may come down, and in some year, when paper is very easy, these numbers may go up. But generally, if you score 50 plus marks, you can get a decent college, a good college. Now, do you think scoring 50 plus or 60 plus is difficult in GATE? No, it is not. Why I am saying? Because if you have a proper strategy, if you have proper plan, if you can prioritize your subjects, it is very easy. I'll show you some examples. Now, look at this slide. This is CS. Apart from mathematics and GA, if you look, there are 4 subjects like CO, DSA, operating system, and DBMS. These 4 core subjects plus mathematics and general ability, the weightage is 74 marks. I have taken this data from last 5 years, and I have taken the average of last 5 years. So, can you see why by focusing only on the few subjects, you can definitely get good score. But be careful, I'm not denying that you have to skip other subjects. You have to prepare them in such a manner that you can solve easy question at least. I'll show some more examples. You can see this stream. There are more than 5 core subjects plus mathematics and GA. The weightage is around 75 marks. In electrical engineering, there are 4 core subjects like network theory, machines, power system, power electronics, plus mathematics and GA. The weightage is around 66 marks. Now, for mechanical, the core subjects are SOM, TOM, thermodynamics, manufacturing, plus maths and plus GA. The weightage is around 73 marks. If you look at iron, now iron, the core subjects are network, controls, and analog and transducer, plus maths and GA, 71 marks. For civil, water resource, structures, geotechnical, transportation, plus maths and GA, weightage is around 82 marks. It's huge. So, first of all, by this data, it is clear that if you plan, if you prioritize the subject, you can easily get good score. Definitely good score. Not only GATE. I'll discuss here some aspects of GA apart from git also. If you have looked this data, GA is common in all the stream and it comprises of 15 marks. That means this subject is important, not only from git point of view. I'll show you one slide. Now, if we'll see these two circles, assume this to be the red one to be git syllabus and the blue one to be government exam syllabus. So, if you look, what do you think? Do you have some data between these two common? Yes. If you see now, the syllabus are common in between these two things up to 80 to 90%. And in which GA is 100% common, 100% same. The syllabus of GA is same. So, GA preparation will help you in GATE. GA preparation will help you in getting direct call from PSUs. GA preparation will help you to clear the government exams. GA preparation will help you in clearing your campus aptitude rounds. That's why you have to give proper time, proper strategy to journal aptitude. Now, we'll be starting with the basic information on journal aptitude. Now, if we'll divide in the broad categories, what are the chapters which comes in journal aptitude? Comes under these categories: number, arithmetic, algebra, geometry, modern maths, DI, reasoning, verbal ability. Now, numbers is very important subject. Arithmetic is also very important because percentage and ratio comes in that category. Modern maths is very important because probability and PNC comes in that category. And take note of one point, that probability comes in GA also and comes in maths also. So by preparing probability, you can you can easily solve the questions from both the categories. So after this, I want to show you some reference books to refer. These are very common books and very good books, like Quantitative Aptitude by R.S. Agrawal, Aptitude by Arihant Publications. You have Logical Reasoning by R.S. Agrawal, Verbal Reasoning by Sijwali. These are all our good books. Now, I want to tell you what today I have bring in this seminar. Now, I want to tell you basic strategies to solve one GA problem. There can be only three strategies to solve. Either solution can be based on formula, or it can be based on tricks, or it can be based on options also. Sometimes you can get the answer from options after analyzing this. So, what I have taken, what I have come with in this seminar, I have taken some questions from GATE and few my own examples. Generally, I take this GATE question in my classroom lectures. What I have seen, these questions are very easy, but while solving student, only 40 to 50% student get the answer correctly. And in that, only 20 to 30% students solve these questions in time, because rest of the student don't know the tricks how to solve these type of questions. So you should know the tricks to solve the questions. So what I will do, I will start with the problems. Now, this is a very simple basic example. This question says, find the number of distinct integer divisor of 60. This is one formula based question. So what is the formula? Formula is very simple. Prime factor, you have to find the prime factor for that number. Okay, I'll solve it in the board. Suppose there is one number n, and you found the prime factor, unique prime factor. And so on. You can have n number of prime factors. So, how to find the number of divisor? Number of divisors will be these powers of prime factors. You have to use these powers. Like if power is x, you have to use x plus 1. That means you have to add 1 in the power. Y plus 1 and z plus 1. I'll multiply all these things. So I'll get the number of distinct factors. Now, see, for the question, the question is like 60. For 60, I can take out prime factors like 2 raised to 2, 3 and 5. These are the prime factorization for 60. Now, if you want to find the number of divisors, what is the power of 2? 2. So I'll add 1. 2 plus 1. What is the power of 3? 1. 1 plus 1. What is the power of 5? 1 plus 1. So the total answer will be 3 into 2 into 2, which is 12. Very easy. Now, I want you to solve one problem based on the same strategy. You don't have to worry about writing these answers. The video will be available in the YouTube channel and our Facebook page also after 2 days. So you can see the solution from there also. Now, I want you all to try the question. This question came in CS 2014 paper for 2 marks. You have to apply the same strategy. You have to first factorize 2014. Okay. Now, first I'll factorize this 2014. When I'll factorize this, I'll get 2 into 1007. Many students will get stuck here. Why? Because 1007 is not easy to factorize. So there is one trick to factorize this. I'll tell you what. You want to check whether this is prime or not. That's the main motive. If it is prime, it cannot be factorized. That's it. So we can check by one method. We have to find square root of this number, 1007. But I'm not interested in the decimal part. I need a rough idea. Since we know that square of 30 is 900, so it will be around 31. Now, this 31, you have to list all the prime numbers below this 31. Like 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, and 31. Now, just check with these numbers only. You don't have to check with all the numbers whether 1007 is divisible by any of the numbers or not. You have to check with these numbers. In that also, you can easily eliminate 2 because it is not divisible by 2. You can easily eliminate 5 because in the unit digit we have 7. 3 also, the addition is 8. So it is not divisible. Now you can easily check with these remaining number with your calci or by manual testing. So this number you will find it is divisible by 19. So that means the prime factorization for 2014 will be 2 into 19 into 53. That means the number of divisors will be, all prime factor has only power 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. The answer is 8. In this question, what I wanted to teach you, how to find the factor of difficult numbers. Because the motive of this question was the same. You should be able to find out the factor of these type of questions. So this is the trick. I think, am I clear? Next question. This is also an example. The probability that given positive integer lying between 1 and 100, both inclusive, is divisible by 2 or 3. So what we have to do in these type of problems, you have to find how many numbers are there, first of all, so that it is divisible by 2 and 3. So for these type of numbers, we have to make Venn diagram for these type of problems. This is universal set, that means total number 1 to 100. Now here I'll make two circles. These numbers are divisible by 2, and these numbers are divisible by 3. So what is common? What is common? Common is LCM of these two. That means the number divisible by 6. So we all know till 1 to 100 there are 16 numbers which are divisible by 6. So 16 will come right. Now if you see for 2 there are 50 numbers which are divisible by 2, but you cannot write 50 because we have already included the 16. Here 34 will come. For this 3, the total numbers, the total possible number of divisible number are 33. So we'll write 33 minus 16, 17 over here. If we'll add these, we'll get 50 plus 17, that is 67. So this is the total number of numbers which are divisible by 2 or 3, okay, or it is by LCM. So what is the probability? Probability will be 67 divided by the complete set, 100. So the answer will be 0.67. This was one simple example. Now I want you to try one other example. Okay, I'll show you the question. So, this is a question. This question came in CS 2014 for 2 marks. I'm giving you 15 seconds or 30 seconds to solve this, to try this, at least try this question. Now, we'll follow the same strategy over here. But here are 3 numbers, 2, 3 and 5. So we'll make 3 circles. This is universal set, 1 to 100. This is number divisible by 2. This is 3, this is 5. What is this then? This part. LCM of 2 and 3, that means 6. LCM of 3 and 5, 15. LCM of 2 and 5, that is 10. But we have something more in common, that is the central part, which is LCM of 2, 3 and 5, which is 30. So for this I'll write over here 30. Now you have to start from inside. How many numbers are there from 1 to 100 which are divisible by 30? Only 3? 30, 60, 90? So I'll write only 3 numbers are possible over here. Correct? Now I'll start with 10 over here. How many numbers are there from 1 to 100 which are divisible by 10? 10, 20, 30, 40 and so on. That means 10 numbers. So should I write 10 over here or 7? 7. Why? Because this 10 is for this whole area. Because we have already counted 30, 60, 90 over here. So we cannot recount over here. You understood? Now we'll come to this 15. 15, there are 6 numbers. So I'll write 3 over here because we have already taken 3. For 6, there are 16 numbers, so we'll write 13 because already we have taken 3 over here. Now we'll come to these bigger numbers. 2, 3, 5, bigger circles, sorry. So 2, you know, okay, overall there are 50 numbers which are divisible by 2. So if I'll add these 7 plus 3, which is 10, 10 plus 13, which is 23, plus you have to subtract this 23 from 50. That means this is 27. The total of this circle will be 50. You can count it. Now come to this. 3. The total number divisible by 3 is 33. You know that. So 33 minus these 3. So 33 minus 19, which is 14. The total of this will be 33. For 5, you know it is very easy, 20 numbers are divisible. So for 5, 20 numbers are divisible, but you have to subtract these. So here it will come 7. The total of these will be 20. Now, I'll add these. This is already 50. This circle is already 50. 50 plus 7 plus 3, 60. 60 plus 14. What is that? 74. Now, don't be in hurry to write 74 divided by 100. The answer is 0.74. No, it is wrong. Why? Question says that he not divisible by 2, 3, 5. That means 74 are divisible. So, not divisible will be 100 minus these 74, which will be 26. So, proper, the correct answer is 26 upon 100, which is 0.26. Got it? Okay. Now, next question. Okay. What is the average of all multiples of 10 from 2 to 198? 2 to 198. Now, I want to first solve this, okay? Then I want to tell you something. Average of multiples of 10 from 2 to 198 is like 10, 20, 30 till 190. What is average? 10 plus 20 plus 30 plus 190 divided by 19. So you have like this. Divide by 19. Can we take 10 common? So we'll get 1 plus 2 plus 3 till 19 divided by 19. If you remember, you have formula for this. Sum of first 10 natural number. What is the formula? It is n plus 1 divided by 2. So for this, we can solve it by using formula, which is 10 into n into n plus 1 divided by 2 upon 19. This will get cancelled. The answer is 100. Now, many students will think, sir, this can be easily solved by Calci also. So why should I remember the formula? I want to stress on 3 points. Please take note of this. First thing, calculator is not allowed in other exams. Calculator is only allowed in GATE. So you should know these tricks, these formulas. Second thing, if you can save some time from the GA part, you can focus more on your core subjects. This is second thing. Now third thing, which is very important and new to all, in GATE 2015, will not be getting physical calculators. Will only be getting the online calculators. And I'm damn sure you are not very versed with the online calculator. So these type of calculation will take more time in online calculator. Because you have to fit the number, then you have to press plus. Okay, it's not like very like you solve in the physical calculator. So you have to have some tricks for the solution. Because every time will not go to Calci to check the answer. Okay, so please learn these tricks. In our classroom sessions, in our e-lecture sessions, we, in every chapter, we try to show the tricks related to everything, every topic, so that you can solve it easily. And we also apply those tricks on the actual GATE problems, like I'm doing here. Okay, now we'll move to next problem. Now, this problem came in EC 2014 paper for 1 mark. Generally, while solving this problem, now student will assume some numbers x, x plus 2 and so on. What the question says, there is a sequence of 12 odd numbers, 12 consecutive odd numbers. That means if the first number is 1, second number is 3, then 5, then 7, so on. And they have given the sum of first 5 numbers and they want sum of last 5 numbers. So don't assume anything in this type of question. I'll show you the trick. What is the trick in this question? I'm assuming these are the places for first 5 numbers. Now, if you remember this, this is one basic concept from your high school, that if you have consecutive odd numbers like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, for example, 5 odd numbers, so what is the average of these 5? Average of these 5 will always be middle number. Will always be middle number. You can add it and you can check. Now, if in that manner, if I want to conclude about this, the average of first 5 will be this middle number. What they have given the sum for first 5, it is 425. Since sum is 425, can you find the average? You just have to divide by 5. You will get 85. Now, I'll put this 85 over here because I got this number, because I know the average is middle number. Now I got this 85, and since numbers are consecutive, can I write other numbers? 85. What will come here? 87. 89. 91. 93. 95. 97. 99, 101, 103. Now, if you look at the last 5 numbers, they wanted the sum of last 5 numbers. Don't add, because we'll apply the same strategy in the reverse order. The average will be this 99. You just multiply this 99 by 5. Again, I'll add one more shortcut. Instead of multiplying 99 by 5, multiply 100 by 5, which is 500, and then subtract 5, you'll get the answer. The answer is 495. So, from this problem, it is very clear that don't think that every problem is calculative. It will take too much time. No. You have to put a right strategy. Okay, now we'll go to the next problem. Wow, such a big information for the problem. Many times students will read this and leave the problem itself. They will not solve at all. This question came in Civil 2014 for 2 marks. And just to surprise you, question is not over yet. The question continues on the second slide also. Okay, so don't afraid of these questions. This question is very easy. So, I have taken this question because of that only. If there is big data, huge number of data, at least try to read it carefully once, what they have given. What they have given that below this paragraph, we have given 2 pie charts and we want so and so answers. That's it. So, in the next slide, what I have done, I have put those 2 pie charts and I have also put the question statement. We'll go to the next slide. The next slide, you can see. There are 2 pie charts. One pie chart says exports of 5 lakh tons. Another pie chart says revenue of 250 crores. Now, what is the question? Question is, what is the ratio? That means they want the ratio. Before I start this problem now, I want to tell you one thing, that in this type of DI question, this is a data interpretation question, first of all. Generally, data interpretation question will come for have some application of percentages. Don't jump in finding the answer for each and every percentage, because many times it will have the same base to cancel out it. You'll see here. I'll tell you. What is the question? Now we'll read the question. What is the ratio of the revenue generated through export of item 1? That means what they want. They want revenue through export of item 1 per kg. That means they want revenue per kg. Now, if you were to calculate revenue per kg, what will you do? You will find the revenue part by calculation, and then you will find the kgs part and you will divide. Don't do like that. What they have asked? They have asked ratio for this revenue per kg for 2 items, item number 1 and item number 4. Now, we'll solve. For item 1, what is the revenue percentage? 12%. So, I'll write 12% in the multiplied by revenue. Revenue, I have denoted this by R. And what is per kg? For item 1, what is the percentage of kg?
11%.
Exports one. Now for item 1, we got revenue per kg. Now, what I'll do? I'll find out the revenue per kg for the item number 4. For item number 4, the revenue is 6%. And kg, it is 22%. Now you can see RE will get cancelled. Now 6 to 22. So what will be the answer? 2 upon 1 into 2 upon 1, which is 4 upon 1.
Since I'm explaining, I have taken this much time. If I were to solve, I can solve this in 15 seconds very easily.
So with this problem, what I want to explain, with this problem, I want to explain that don't jump in solving if you know how to find the percentages. You have the calculus, you'll start solving, you'll start finding the percentages. Now, you got this answer, 4:1. Now, we'll move to next problem. Okay. Now, this type of question, it's like very easy. I'm sure some of students may be knowing how to solve this question. Okay, but there are still, I found in the classroom that many of students find it difficult. Okay, but this question is literally very easy. You just need to know the particular strategy, particular way to solve this question. Now, the question says, you have to find the value of this. Can I assume it to be x? Now square on both the sides. If I square on both the sides, this big square will, square root will go. So it will be 12 plus 6. Now, what is this? Again x. Can I substitute over here? Now this is very simple quadratic equation. You can very easily solve. Now I'll get the answer as 4.
So x is 4.
The other answer is -3, which is not in the option. You have to select the 4. So what we have learned over here, don't go by the appearance of the question. It may be very easy. It might be very easy. So you just have to think. Okay. Now we'll go to next question. I want you all to try this question. I'll give only 30 seconds to solve it. This question came in civil for 1 marks. This is last year's paper, 2014's paper. One thing I want to tell you about this question. If you are thinking that you have to take out your pen, take out your calculator to solve this question, you are wrong. This can be solved in mind itself. So just try it. Okay, now I'll solve. Thanks for the replies. I got many answers, but out of this, only one person is correct. Okay. Now I'll solve this. Okay. I'm using a marker just to explain you. Okay. This is first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year. The base is 5 million. And it is written clearly in the question that it is getting increased 20% annually. So if we keep this base every year 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. No, it's not that way. First year if you increase by 20%, it will become 6 because 20% of 5 is 1. Next year if it increase by 6, it will be 7.2 because 20% of 6 is 1.2. So assuming this, if I am taking this base only, 5, suppose 5, okay, I am not increasing. So every year there will be addition of 1, 1, 1. In 5 years, you will get the population as double. But
here the population is getting increased. Because this year you have to take 20% of this, third year you have to take 20% of this. That means your answer can never be 5. Your answer has to be less than 5. So if you look at the options, there is only one option, which is A, in which there is no 5. The actual answer is 3.8 something, but you don't have to solve, you don't have to find the exact answer. They have given the range for that purpose only, that you have to guess this answer. Okay? Now, we'll move to next question. Again, whole lot of data. Okay. So, as I told you earlier, please don't panic. At least try to read once. This is logical reasoning question actually. This question came in CL 2014 of 2 marks. Okay. Why I have taken this question? Generally, I have seen when student will start solving this question, they'll make a big matrix, putting crosses and checks. Yeah, that is a traditional method. I know that. But I want to tell you some tricks for this. What are the tricks? Just read the data and also read the options. If I read the data, in the first, they have given there are 6-story building and 6 persons are living. Now, the first line of data is Anuj lives on even number floor. If you look at the option, we don't get any idea because every number is even. Same information is given for Bhola also. Now we'll go ahead. Chandan does not live on any of the floors below Faisal. We don't have any information about Faisal, so we cannot comment it. Dilip does not live on floor number 2. For Dilip, all the option, you'll not find 2. Ishwar does not live on full floor immediately above and immediately below Bhola. No relevance because we don't know about Bhola. Faisal lives 3 floor above Dilip. This is one information which is important. I think it is important. Faisal is Dilip plus 3. Now we'll look at the options. Faisal should be Dilip plus 3. In the first option, Dilip is 1 and Faisal is 4. That means it is correct. Second option also there is 1 and 4. That means it is also correct by the condition. But in third and fourth, you can see the third and fourth, the data is not satisfying this condition. So, can we eliminate CD? Yes, definitely. We can eliminate. So, now we have to eliminate one option between A and B. So, we need to find some data for that. If we'll check with A and B, the options Chandan, Dilip, Ishwar, Faisal, the data is same. Only the difference is Anuj and Bhola. So, we have to find some relation of Anuj or Bhola with somebody else. So, you can see the line just before this Faisal line. Ishwar does not live on a floor immediately above or below Bhola. Now, look at the options. Ishwar is 3 in option 1 and Bhola is 2. That means Ishwar is immediately above Bhola. So, it is not satisfying the question. Data, that means the answer will be B. What I have tried to explain you here is like, don't always start jumping to solve the question, making big matrix and all that. Here you have to go by the options. So you have to practice in such a manner so that you are very through with these kind of strategies so that you can very easily score your 15 marks in GA. Because GA, 15 marks, scoring 15 marks is very easy. Very, very, very easy and in less time. So that rest of the time you can utilize solving your core subjects. Now, on the verbal ability, I want to share one point. Verbal ability generally is very easy. If your English speaking is above average or average, you can very easily score good marks in your verbal reasoning. But I want to highlight one point over here. Generally, verbal reasoning question comes from grammar basis, passage basis, small passages are there, synonym, very closes in meaning, like that. But last year, what happened? There was one question in verbal ability, which was combination of verbal ability plus general awareness. I like the question a lot. So what I did, I asked this question to my students in the class, and I was surprised that almost 60 to 70% of the class gave wrong answer for the question. So I want to give you the same question. I want answers from your side. I just want to check. So this is that question. Now, I want answers. Since this question doesn't require any calculation, you can give me answer in 15 seconds. See, I have received your replies. Thanks. And I cannot count because there are huge replies. But I can judge with the appearance that very, very less number of people have given the correct answer. Generally, what students think, from 60 it went to 65. That means it is appreciated. No, it is wrong. You have to think in this manner. Now, to buy $1, we have to pay extra rupees. That means our rupee value got depreciated. So, increase in rupee as compared to dollar, there is depreciation. Suppose it would have been 50. That means there is appreciation in the price. And the option they have given, keeping verbal ability part in mind. So many of you gave the right answer, but lot of answers were incorrect. So please just have little bit knowledge or general awareness, because this appreciation and depreciation of rupees is not from English. It's from your finance terms, the normal basic newspapers, news channels. That's it. If you have any queries regarding the session, you can definitely ask right now. Or you can also mail your queries to info@thegateacademy. Hope you like this session. What is the idea of this session? It is the basic thing. For GA, don't only be dependent on CALCI, please. And this time too, not at all, because this time there is online calculator. You will not get too much time to solve using online calculator, because you are not thorough, you are not versed with online calculator. So don't be dependent. Try to learn as many as tricks you can learn, because this 1 hour I cannot show you all the tricks. There are lots of tricks. Every chapter will have lots of formulas and lots of tricks, so that every problem can be solved. I'll tell you basic data. A general student who is not solving with the trick will take 3 to 5 minutes to solve one question. And if you are solving with trick, you can solve the same question from 15 to 30 or maximum 45 seconds. Not more than that. This is my experience from last 8 years. So you have to learn these tricks anyhow. Thank you. For any, I'll check the queries. If you have any queries, I'll answer the queries. Very good question. One student asked question, if I only qualify the gate, will I get the call, direct call from PSUs? Very good question. Very interesting question. No. Only qualifying the gate will not help you. You have to score good marks. I'll tell you general trend from the last year's information, this gate information. Suppose you are from ECAA IIM background, you should have a rank of 250 to 400 to get a PSU call, direct call. And if you have a mechanical, so you can extend this to 500 to 600 rank, then definitely you get a call from PSU. But only qualifying will not help at all. So you need to have good score, you need to have good marks to get a direct call from your PSU. And one student also gave one question, that what is the weightage of general ability in direct government job exams? So it depends. There are few exams in which general ability is of only 20% weightage. But there are few exams in which the weightage is 35 to 40% also. So for government job exam also it is important. And the best part is syllabus is same for both. So while preparing one, you are preparing for that also. And just imagine if you are giving that exam which has 40% GA weightage, then it's good. It's good for scoring. I'll take a few more doubts. I'll tell you, one question came, which is the good book for journal English? Because journal ability also have the part of English. There is one book called Objective English. Objective English. It is very good book. You can by this title, there is only one book in the market. Okay. Objective English. You can refer this, and this book starts from very basic. So you can refer this, and also you can refer that book, Verbal Reasoning, which I showed in the reference book section. You can go to this video and see the book name. Now, very good question. Where to learn tricks? First of all, I'll tell you, you'll find very less book for the tricks. Okay, you have to have to join some classes, some institute, or else you can refer Vedic mathematics. But in many of the formulas in Vedic mathematics is in Sanskrit. Okay, there are English versions, but it is very difficult for a student. Okay, to understand. You can try Vedic mathematics. The book name is Vedic mathematics. You can try to learn the tricks. But I'll tell you one thing. The Vedic mathematics will tell you only the tricks, but how to apply the question they'll not tell you. So it's better to join some good institute and having good faculty, so that they'll teach you about the tricks. In fact, you can tell the faculties, please, if you find that if he's solving by a very long method, if it is taking more than 2 to 2.5 minutes to solve one problem, you can request him, sir, can we have another way to solve, so that we can solve in less time? There will be very few, very rare questions which will take 2 minutes to solve in GA. Very, very rare. I'll take next question. Good question. Vocabulary preparation. For vocab, it is not one night or 1 month or 5 months job. You need to regularly keep reading the newspaper. You have to maintain one book in which you have to write the difficult words in which you are finding difficulty. And there is one book, Word Power Made Easy. There are two versions for this book. One is very big, very thick, but for GATE it is not required. There is one smaller book from the same author, Word Power in 30 days. Okay, you can refer that book. That book is also good, and from GATE point of view, it is sufficient. You don't have to buy that thick one book. Okay, very good question. One student has asked whether joining Abacus classes will help. Not at all. Never ever. You'll waste your time. It's better to learn Vedic mathematics than Abacus, because Abacus needs a device. You'll not be allowed to take the device in the classroom. So don't join any class for that. Huh, if you want to learn Abacus as your hobby, you can learn. I'll take next question. Okay, one student has asked a very good question about his graduation score. I'll tell you, this is one myth, huh? Only toppers will go to IITs and IISc. It's not like that. That's why at the GATE Academy, we keep one post-GATE guidance seminar. And I think there will be live sessions also on that. There will be documents, there will be book for that, so that you can refer, and it will help you a lot to find a proper college. So I'll suggest you wait for that session, and it will clear all your doubts about that. One student has asked, do I teach this GA in this institute? Yes, I do teach. I take lectures in this institute only. So you can definitely, if you want to join, you can join. No issues in that. Again, I want to reiterate, some student has asked the question about GRE word list. No need. I'm telling you that book, Word Power in 30 days. It is best book. Just refer that. But keep one thing in mind. If you want to improve, excel throughout your career, start reading newspaper on daily basis. Start reading the Business Standard, Economic Times, your paper, your technical publication, the journals, which I think for IT you have some books, magazines, you can read those. slowly, slowly, your vocab and your grammar will automatically get improved. Don't worry about that. There's one question about the backlog. If you have backlog in 7th sim, can you write 2015 gig? Definitely you can write, no issues in that. But while producing the final year this results, you have to have clear all clear result. Okay, right, you can give, because of right now it is July, so you will be having attempts, so definitely you can solve, you can clear the exam. There is one very good question. Which is better class? Sitting live in the classroom or attending online classes? I'll tell you, generally as a faculty, I'll tell you, if you have access, if you don't have any problem of traveling, if you have time, then classroom program is good. But if you are working professional, if you don't have traveling to a very long distance, then live class is good. Now, I differentiate between the quality. If you're thinking that quality is different, not at all. Here also, in live class also, we'll clear all your doubts. In the classroom program also, we'll clear all the doubts. And also, from study material point of view, from content point of view, you'll get everything, okay. So you don't have to worry about whether it is live class or classroom class. You'll get complete guidance. Don't worry about that. Thank you. Okay, there is one good question. Apart from R.S. Agrawal or Arihant, is there any other book to prepare? There is one book called as Quantum Cat. It is for cat, but the way they have explained the things, it is very good. You can refer that book. And it will help you in difficult papers also. That is a good book. I'll take the next question. There's one question. I read out the question. I understand that core subjects can be studied in short period of time. Is it possible to develop aptitude in short time? Very good question. Short time, if you tell me, sir, the exam is in Feb and we are in January, can we prepare for aptitude? Not at all possible. You need to have at least 4 months preparation for aptitude. Otherwise, it is not possible. Achha, why I'm saying 4 months? Because you will be having other subjects also to prepare. You cannot set aside other subjects and you can start prepare for GA. Not. You have to prepare with the GA. So, at least 3 to 4 months of regular practice of 1 or 2 hours will suffice. You will be very good in GA, at very good level in GA. One question from one student. Can we prepare on our own? It is a very open-ended question, but it is very difficult. Okay. Because I have seen some students who have tried their own on their own, but they have scored not very great marks. But after that, they have realized and they have joined the classes, some institute, any institute. But they told me that institute effect is there, definitely. Guidance is must for anything. So preparation on your own is difficult. So it is advisable that you join some classes. It will be good for you, for your scores. Very good question. Should I join a 2-year program or 1-year program? Now I'll explain. If you feel your technical knowledge is not sound, your marks and technical subjects are consistently low, so I think you should go for a 2-year program. If you are good at technical subjects, you can opt for 1-year program. No issues in that. One question is there. I'll read out the question. Whether it is possible to get core subject clarification immediately through correspondence gate. This is the same question that you want to study on your own. Correspondence gate will not help you in very big manner. It will help you in some manner, because correspondence gate and reading from some standard author, there is one difference. In correspondence gate material, you have best from point from all the author books in one book. So it is good, because you don't have to study loads of book, because all the required thing for gate is there only in one book. But if it is possible for you, go for this classroom program, whether it is live class, online class, or classroom programs. And for this live class, I want to tell you one very important thing. Suppose one lecture happens, and after that, if you have any doubt, we have forum in which student can interact with the faculty. You can post any doubt anytime and faculty will resolve all your doubts. So this is the best part of this live class. And also live class, there is also one more advantage. Suppose by any chance if you have missed the lectures, the lecture is still available, so you can view the lecture later on. You and after viewing the lecture, you can ask the doubts also later on in that online discussion forum. So it is very good platform to learn. Okay, almost all queries got over, but if you have any queries, you can mail the queries at info@thegateacademy.com. We'll try to resolve all your queries by mail. Thank you. Thank you for attending the session. Thanks a lot.